Oh, I'd love to have heard John Baptist preach, wouldn't you? I'd like to have seen this man when God says, John, you've been here 20 years now, you better go out and preach. I told you this morning it takes God 20 years to make a man. It took him 20 years to make John Baptist, and then he preached for 6 months. You boys went to Bible school for 6 months and been preaching 20 years. No wonder you're dry. You better go back. Go back to the wilderness. Go back to the desert. Get into the loneliness. There's nothing on God's earth like silence. Just take your Bible. Forget everything.
For the Lord God does nothing without revealing his secret to his servants, the prophets. The lion has roared. Who will not fear? The Lord God has spoken. Who can but
come? He went into the wilderness until the day of his going forth. There's nothing on God's earth like silence. Just take your Bible, forget everything and everybody, and shut yourselves away till that you have a new revelation from God himself. A lot of people want Jesus to come today because they're scared of suffering, that's why.
I speak unto thee this day, and I say that if a man had a dog, and he loved the dog, and he trained the dog, and the dog strayed from the man and went off after other dogs, went running as he pleased, I say the dog would prove to be dysfunctional unto the man because he lacked in loyalty. That is, he was not faithful to the master who had put his time, his training, his effort into him to be his own. And I say that the man would grow disgruntled with the dog because of his disobedient behavior. Now I say likewise that a man can take a dog, train a dog, and the dog would be exceedingly loyal unto him. I say this day that it is me, the living God, who looks for the ones who will be loyal, who will be faithful, who will be obedient unto me. For I say when any man will declare that he loves me, I say that he's meant to prove the same by his faithfulness, by his loyalty, by his obedience unto me. Now I say you are living in times when men and women are loyal to nothing except the love of self. That is, they will seek to exalt themselves, they will seek to have their way, they will seek to do as they please. And I say it is truly the God of self they are serving, they are not serving me. But I say it is me, the living God, who is searching throughout the earth for the ones who will be faithful, who will be true, who will be loyal unto me and obey my commands. Now I say this day there are many, they think they love me, yet I say when the testing and the trying of their faith comes upon them, it is not me that they love at all. For I say they are serving a multitude of other lovers, other gods, and I say they are faithful to the same. That is, they are faithful in their service to demons, they are faithful in their service to self, but I say they are not faithful unto me. And I say they imagine that somehow they get by, but it absolutely is not true. For I say that I, the living God, do look upon a man, I look upon a woman, to see if it is me that they are steady to believe. That is, are they steadily believing and trusting in me, or are they ever wavering, turning aside, and taking up a multitude of other gods? I say this day that I, the living God, never called you to be in service to a multitude of gods, but I say that I've called you to be in service to me. That is, ever faithful and true unto me as the one you are meant to please. Now I say you are living in times when multitudes have strayed from me, gone a-whoring, taken up many other gods, and think somehow that I, the living God, am meant to be blessing them. But I say, when you truly consider how stupid that is, I say they have become dull and dumb. And I say they will bow to the very forces of oppression that have come in upon them because of their whoredom against me. And I say they will bow to other lovers and think somehow they get by. Now I say this day, be thankful that I, the living God, am the one God you are meant to serve. You are not meant to bow to any other source. That is, you are not meant to be worshiping yourself, for the same fool will take you to hell. I say you are meant to be serving me, walking uprightly in my way. And I say you are meant to be thankful that I give thee the truth and the light upon the path. Now I say this day, when you look upon what disloyalty does, I say that it brings disintegration, I say that it brings despair, and I say that it brings many sorrows. And I say when men are disloyal towards me, that is unfaithful, untrue, I say they are the ones who gravitate by wrath unto them. For I say it is me, the living God, who is jealous, and I say when a man or a woman will make vows unto me, they are meant to keep the same. That is, they are meant to be ever guided, directed, and corrected by me. And I say they are meant to walk in the straight, the narrow way that I provide, ever made glad that it is me that they serve. Now I say this day when you look upon the way that light of living God to intend, I say it is the way that is truth and light. And I say when you will be walking in that way, then I say you are found pleasing unto me. But I say when you go in any other way than the way that I offer, the way that I provide, I say you go in the way of a fool. And I say in that way you will be overwhelmed and devoured. I say this day when I, the living God, do give to you the truth, the light, and the mercy, I say walk in the same. And I say be made glad each day that it is me you can look to and believe. For I say if you will be coming forth in that which I give you, then yes, you are guided by me. And I say you are given the blessedness, the strength, the truth, and the mercy revealed. Now I say this day when you look upon the ways that men take themselves by going a-whoring from me, I say they only complicate their lives on this earth. That is, because they lie to themselves, they lie to me, and I say they go on in lies. And I say they become ensnarled and embroiled and taken in lies because they are deceiving. Who it is, I do not know. For I say that I, the living God, am not deceived by all of their lies, for they are the fools. I say this day, seek to be faithful, seek to be true, seek to be loyal unto me. For I say it is the obedient who find the abundance of my life. But I say that the disobedient, the rebels who think they can have their own way, are going in the way of stubborn, proud fools. And I say it is fools who are beaten with many stripes. Now I say this day that I, the living God, do look upon a man who is faithful and true, and I say that he's treasure unto me. And I say there can be 100 babblers and gabblers who are chasing the wind, boasting of how great they are, exalting themselves and bragging on their great works. To me they are fools. But I say that the one who is faithful and true and steady in his service unto me, I say that he will receive the reward of the righteous. And I say that he's treasure unto me. I say this day that men have grown so engrossed with numbers because they are pursuing the ways of the world, they have forgotten honesty and integrity in me. That is, they have forgotten and abandoned the way of being faithful and true, being loyal unto me. And I say they've gone whoring, taken up the ways of the world, and think in their flash and their trash, that proves they are some great thing. But I say that I, the living God, never called men to be exalting themselves, boasting of how great they are, but I say that I've called men to worship me. Now I say this day, in the wayward, a perverse, a vile, a wicked generation, consider that it is me, the living God, who does give unto you the way of newness of life. And I say, consider likewise that through me you are given the truth and the light upon the path. For I say, it is only through me that you are guided, directed, and brought forth. And I say, it is only through me that you are given the purpose and the plan. I say, therefore, be thankful, to be faithful, to be true, to be steady in me. Now I say this day that I, the living God, do see the liars, the cheaters, the schemers, who think they are getting by on me, but I say they are fooling only themselves. For I say that I, the living God, absolutely am not mocked by carnal men. And I say when men in all of their vanity imagine they are getting by on me, they are imagining lies. And I say they are living in deception of their own conception because their hearts are far from me. I say, be thankful even now to be able to be counted worthy to be called good and faithful unto me. For I say, when you truly consider, that is the reward of the righteous. For I say that men may receive acclaim and fame and proclamation as to how great they are by other men. But I say, tomorrow the same can flee away. But I say, when a man will remain ever faithful and true unto me, loyal in his service, loyal in his love and affection, then I say such a man is worthy of me. And I say that he will indeed be found abiding in my way. I say this day, do not strive to be recognized for who and what you think you are, but I say strive to be pleasing me. That is, by accepting my humility way and being guided forth in the same. I say there are far too many in these times, they look to be recognized, applauded, and approved of men. It is all for naught. For I say in the end they will be proven to be utter fools. For I say when men are striving for recognition and acceptance of men, I say they are striving in vain. For I say that all of their striving will take them nowhere except into pride and down the road to hell. I say this day that pride is abomination unto me, yet I say so much of what poses to be works for me is nothing but pride. And I say that it's done to gain recognition, to gain acceptance, it is all in vain. I say that by the living God do not call you to strive to be recognized, but I say that I call you to labor for me. That is, to be faithful, to be true, to be steady in the way that I give thee the way of my life. For I say, when you will be coming forth in the way that I give, then I say you are uplifted in me. And I say you are given the strength to continue in the straight, the narrow way. Now I say, this day count it a privilege to believe upon me, to trust me, and obey me each day. And I say, be thankful that in the trying of your faith you can be proven to be true unto me. For I say you are meant to put up the shield of faith and not fall down to fear of the wicked and succumb to the same. Nor are you meant to go whoring because the pressure is upon you. But I say you are meant to realize that it is me, the living God, who will give you the strength to endure. It is me, the living God, who will guide you through the pressure, and you can come forth ever rejoicing in me. For I say, if it is me that you keep on trusting, believing, and looking unto, then you are guided in life. And I say you are given the hope, the strength, the truth, and the mercy of who I am. I say this day that I, the living God, do intend that my people would keep on loving, keep on serving, keep on following me. And I say that I do intend that my people would be guided forth in righteousness, because it is me that they want to please. I say this day, do not give yourself to any other god, any other lover, and be proven to be a fool. But I say, be ever faithful, steady, and obedient unto me, for I am thy God. Now I say this day, in a time of foolishness, a time of vanity, vexation, and pride, consider that you are given great privilege to obey me. That is, to be uplifted and brought forth, guided and directed in my way. Consider likewise that you are meant to be my peculiar people, a treasure unto me. That is, you are meant to be partakers of that which I give you day by day. And I say you are meant to be thankful that in me you are uplifted, guided, and brought forth. And I say you are meant to be thankful that through me you are directed and instructed in my way. I say thank me and praise me even now that you can continue to love, to serve, to obey me. Thank me and praise me even now that you are given my light each and every day. For I say you are not meant to be vessels of dishonor in a dark and sin-sick world, but I say you are meant to be ever faithful, true, and loyal unto me. For I say when man does look for loyalty in what it is that he puts his training into, I say it is because he wants to make use of the same. I say that I, the living God, do put my training into those that are meant to be loyal unto me. I say, when a man has been trained and given much of my truth, and he proves to be dishonorable, disloyal, and unfaithful, such a man is marked as a fool. And I say that he's given the stripes that are the retribution of fools. I say, when you hear the sorrowful, woeful tales of fools, consider this. Consider that they went a-whoring. Consider they grew drunk on pride. Consider they were lovers of self more than lovers of me. And I say, do not be swelling up in false compassion and pity upon fools who have chosen their way. But I say, realize you are meant to keep ever faithful and true sober in me, and to walk uprightly each day in the way of humility, the way that I provide, living in and proclaiming repentance to a sin-sick world. Thank me and praise me that you do not need to be bound under the fury of my wrath revealed in the agonies of the damned, but you can walk at peace in me.
Repent.